Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
My dear friends, in our Christian life journey, this is a unique experience. Everything will not go rosy. Suddenly you will find in between so many thorns. Don't get stuck up with the thorns. You should have the something to scissor, to cut off, or to prune and move on in life. The experience of Paul, he was being almost humiliated at Athens. The people of Athens are educated people, wise people, they were known as. And when he was talking about Christ, they were listening. When Jesus will rise again, he is our Savior, when he said, they all laughed. He is coming with the God and he will rise from death, it seems. He was almost humiliated. He has to move away from there. He might have been wondering. In the night, God gave me the vision. Go to Mesopotamia. And I obeyed the Lord. Now what have I got? It's a terrible experience. You go and suddenly you get stuck up with some problems, some issues. You feel as though you are humiliated. No. He said, life for me is Christ and dying is profit. He was holding on to confession of his faith in the Lord and the word of God. He never left. And when he was holding on to the word, we know the Holy Spirit, who was absent, as though he was absent, suddenly appeared with glory. So in the dark moments of our life, the Holy Spirit hides in the word of God. And when we hold on to the word and our confession of faith in Christ, he once again appears with the power and glory. That's what we read in Isaiah 59. Verse 19 onwards, when the enemy comes like the flood to finish you up, to take you completely with the root, the Holy Spirit will come carrying the flag in his hands to raise up your standard and to prove to the world that you are the child of the Lord. You are with the mighty power of God. Now, Paul, he is moving to another place. They are moving from Athens. They left and they went to Corinth. And they found a man called Aquila and his wife Priscilla. They were chased away from Rome. Birds of the air, they joined together. So Paul was one side chased away. Other side, Aquilas and Priscilla, they were chased away and they stayed together. God takes care of us. And as he was going and preaching the word of God, there also, once again, a problem came, arguments came, and Paul could have thought, thank God, at least I have a couple now, a family who will take care of me. He said, no, I am not come to this world to eat or drink or to rest. If that was the need, I would have rested in Tarsus in my house. I have given my life to God. Let anything happens, nothing will stop me. He immediately confesses, Jesus Christ is the Lord and I will live for him. So he shook up the garments of the people in Corinth and he went to the Gentiles. My dear friends, how long this man will go on like this? His whole life was that. He goes and works for God. Suddenly the enemy comes and falls on him. And people make fun of him. They throw him intellectually, sometime like place like Philip, we find where they were in Lystra, Iconium. They literally caught him and put him into the jail, made him naked, and beat him with the rods many hours to hang in the jails. But in all these moments, Paul never went back. He was holding on to his faith and confessing. It is easy for you and me to speak about it. It's not easy to live. And that was the story of Paul. That was the story of every man of God. If we read in the 2 Kings chapter 2, we find Elijah is going to heaven within no time. And his disciple Elisha, who trusted the master, he was such a rich man. He had 10 bulls to plow, plenty of land. When God called him, he left everything. He used the plow for burning to cook the food, and he used all the bulls as food and gave it his disciple. Now I have nothing to hold except to my God. I will not turn back. He went like that. But in his life, a very big problem. His own guru, Elijah, says, he is not showing him any interest. But he trusts in the Lord. And when he went in Gilgal, the prophets in Gilgal, they say, your guru is going to be taken away. Stupid fellow, foolish fellow, remain here. What we eat, you also can eat. You stay with us. The world will not allow us to go ahead in the Lord. It will say, stay in the world and be happy with the world. No, many things will not be clear to you. Your security is only the Lord. So Elisha says, the Lord is with me. And all of you keep quiet. The Lord is with me. That is the word. Even to the prophets he said, holding on to the word. When you hold on to the word and when you confess your faith in Christ, Holy Spirit is hidden and he will come out. And when he crossed Gilgal, he crossed Jordan, he crossed Jericho, everywhere obstacles, everywhere prophets, the so-called servants of God are against him. But he never left the word of God. He never left to confess his faith in Christ Jesus. And the Holy Spirit came with mightily. Now the guru himself went away. We never see him taking him, blessing him. No. Even in the last moment he is going to heaven, God is coming to take him. In that moment, I do not know whether he thought, my servant is going to become double than, bigger than me. Maybe, I do not know. And he did not bless him. But God blessed him. In life journey sometime, your day will be dark. That's what Jesus said. I will go away for a little while. And you will be wondering, what's happening? Where is the master? Where is the master? I am left all alone. No. After a little while, you will see. You will hold on to my faith. And in your confession of the word of God, in your confession of faith that Christ is my Lord, I have trusted him. That's what in 2 Timothy 1:12, Paul said, I know in whom I have trusted. And the one whom I have trusted is capable enough to take care of me. And the Lord took care of him. That's what Jesus said. In this world, your experience will be like this. You will be crying in sorrow. But the world will say, oh, he trusted God and look what is he going through. No. your God. When you confess, the Holy Spirit of God will come with flag to raise up your standard. Means when God allows you to go through one struggle, and if you remain faithful to God, God will lift you to next level of glory and honor. In order to lift you to a new anointing, to new stage of glory, God allows you to go through. And if you fall back, God will fall where you are fallen, and he will try to clean up your wounds and try to bandage you and again lift you. But if you move with him with courage and confession of your faith and word of God, he will be there to take you to another next level. Now Elisha became a mighty apostle than Elijah. Yes, God will take care of you. Close your eyes and pray to the Lord. Be not dismayed. Whatever be the tide, God will take care of you. Beneath these wings of love, you abide. God will take care of you. Surrender your life to him. He will take care of you. Hold on to faith. Hold on to the word of God. Yes.